I'm Francis Deng, Deputy Editor of Radiology in Training. This Radiology in a Minute video summarizes the article by Johanna Ospel and colleagues on infarct patterns and volumes in large vessel stroke. The purpose was to investigate the association of qualitative and quantitative infarct variables on imaging with clinical outcomes. The study was a retrospective analysis of a global multi-center clinical trial enrolling patients undergoing thrombectomy for a large vessel occlusion stroke. Imaging was performed at 24 hours post-treatment with non-contrast head CT and/or MRI, including diffusion-weighted imaging. Study radiologists evaluated whether infarct involved both gray and white matter or predominantly gray matter. They classified infarcts as territorial, as seen on the left, when any areas were larger than 2 centimeters, and otherwise, as seen on the right, as scattered. They determined whether the infarcts involved the corticospinal tract, as these cases did. Finally, they manually segmented the infarcts to determine the volume. The outcome was good functional independence defined as modified Rankin score 0 to 2 at 90 days. Those patients who achieved a good functional outcome tended to have lower infarct volumes. After multivariable adjustment, involvement of both gray and white matter, a territorial pattern, and involvement of the corticospinal tract were all independently associated with lower rates of a good outcome at 90 days, even accounting for total infarct volume. In conclusion, there is a strong association between infarct morphology and clinical outcome independent of infarct volume in patients with large vessel occlusion treated with thrombectomy. Considering these qualitative variables, in addition to infarct volume, could improve outcome prediction in ischemic stroke, providing prognostic information to patients and their families, and potentially guiding rehabilitation.